have James Cook cut them.
A few weeks ago, and he didn't really classify that as a fight. I think that game would have been closer more to wrestling, and people disagreeing, but that was an all-out fight right
all
there.
All he was waiting for.
Jeff is so tiny.
There's Jeff Piar, the reporter for ESPN. There's Casey guys going after him and pounding on
him. Who's hitting him from behind there?
Casey's guys.
That's why the did he hit Casey?
No, Casey Kane's crew is in the same garage as the 24. At the shop.
Is that Roger Penske?
Yeah, he's in the middle.
Is he in the middle?
He's like 80 years old.
Some bumps and bruises from that one on a lot of folks' part.
Yeah, there were a lot of punches thrown in that one.
You know, we all knew, and just as Jimmy was pointing out there, we all knew that with this format, that all of this was going to ramp up the pressures and everything that was going to take place on the racetrack.
Drivers and teams and cars are back in the garage area after the race, watching our telecast earlier and seeing what happened. So, championship standings headed to the final race of the Eliminator Round, where four will be eliminated. And look at this. How close could it be for that elimination spot? And of course, if somebody wins in Phoenix as a championship eligible driver, that changes that whole picture also. So there'll be desperate people at Phoenix racing for the win.
Yes, must see, and I'm glad we're going to be there and be a part of it.
So SportsCenter's coming up next. Ricky Craven in our ESPN studios, ready to continue the coverage of a wild night in Texas. And next weekend, Saturday, the Nationwide Series, Chase Elliott could be crowned champion. And next Sunday, the final race of the Eliminator Round. We're going to host race for Heroes 500 for Phoenix, both on ESPN, next weekend. Jimmy Johnson wins tonight, but they'll all be talking about Gordon, Keselowski, and Harvick post-race.